I think it's confirming the ability of this class of drug in terms of cardio and renal protection, really. Although there is another trial that doesn't seem to see the same with one of our SGLT2. We'll have to learn from that. Anyway, going back to the DAPA-CKD, clearly shows us that these drugs works. The population studies in these two trials are so similar, maybe some more microalbuminuric in the DAPA-CKD, but clearly are what I would define a outstanding results for all of us and for the patients, because these drugs might become extremely important and possibly positioned differently in the algorithm we follow to treat patients with diabetes. I mean, with metformin or possibly before metformin. The nephrologist will get very excited. It was sort of expected from diabetologists, because the fact we see in cardio and renal protection is quite rapid and nothing that we would expect in a say less driven by the improvement in glycemic control. So there is some independent mechanism that is driven by these drugs and clearly works in patients without diabetes. There were different pathologies, IgA nephropathy, focal segmental glomerulosclerosis, hypertensive nephropathy, and we will have to learn more of the specific mechanisms that are activated or driven by SGLT2 antagonists in delaying or the progression of this disease in a non-diabetic setting, if I may. So it's evidence-based medicine, so it wakes up the nephrologist in clinic. Shall I use this drug, and when do I use it, and how it works exactly, and what are the mechanism of action? That could open new avenues, new targets for other treatment. So really exciting times, I think, for renal nephrologists and the renal teams. Or it has to be, because even without, well, EMPA renal will look, is been looking at a wider population with also a more broader spectrum of GFRs, if I will remember. And I mean, I think already today we can actually, these drugs do protect your heart and your kidney, they just should be used, and period. They're really, the effect they have conferred, at least in the diabetic population, is dramatic. And we should be using them more and more, I believe. Importantly, I think there is a reassurance on the amputation scare that was reasoned by the study on good cannabis closing, which wasn't confirmed in credence. And now with DAPA, we don't see that sort of predisposition to more amputation or in the diabetic foot and etc. So that is a reassurance. These are pretty much safe drugs, and I think if you look at DAPA with the recent DAPA HF, with a fantastic study, I think they rarely work so well, and dramatic effect on heart failure, and so cardiologists are all excited as well. Nephrology should also be excited now. Because these are drugs that cover really a broad spectrum of disease, which are affecting most of all but most of the diabetic population and also non-diabetic population. If you remember, the heart failure data is also in patients without diabetes. So again, important class of drug. A bit more data or idea on the mechanism of action there in terms of fluids and interstitium and circulating volume. Seems to be preserved with the SGLT2, so better perfusion. Maybe it's true also for the kidney, who knows? But dramatic and important effect. More to learn, and really, it is an interesting diuretic, I would say. It is a diuretic, and it has this incredible beneficial effect on the cardiovascular renal system.